What?
Whoa, I'm loud up in this microphone.
Really loud, yeah. Oh, that's way better.
Welcome to the Cornwall Styling Show, people. Yay, we have an amazing audience here tonight.
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited!
We have people from all over the world here.
All over the world.
Where are these country people from?
I have no idea. Here? Somewhere where there's a lot of trees. A
lot of trees?
No, they're from Washington State.
Washington State.
Well, some of them, yeah.
Oh my God, did you bring medicinal marijuana with you? All right.
Yeah, let's poke it.
I love it. You guys, we have a great show for you this week. We have Black Angel Down. They are going to be live in studio with us here in just a little bit. Super excited.
Very exciting.
To talk with them. They have some big shows coming up and some different amazing things.
Yes. But
first, we're going to get to one of our favorite things that we love to do, and that is celebrity gossip.
Oh, let's talk about it.
This is great because Tim pays no attention to anything.
Yeah,
or listen to the radio.
Really, all it
is
you telling me about what's going on with people in the world.
I love it. So there's this beef between Kanye and Justin Timberlake.
Uh-huh.
Apparently, Kanye at one of his concerts like went off about Justin Timberlake and his song Suit and Tie. And said that it wasn't any good, like it's not, you know, it's like crap basically.
Uh-huh.
First of all, I went to number one, so like crap on you, Kanye. Second of all, Justin was on Saturday Night Live this week.
Uh-huh.
And he sang a song, Suit and Tie, and he changed the lyrics up.
Oh.
Yes.
And talking trash about Kanye.
Yes, he did. So he changed, it was something about this stuff, my shit's so sick and blah, 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 blah. So he changed it up and he said, my hit's so sick, it's making rappers acting dramatic.
Oh.
Yeah, so he changed it up and it's all over the media, like
That's
everywhere.
Crazy.
I know. So Kanye's halfway across.
All he does is talk trash about people.
He needs to shut his mouth and just make music.
Yeah. Is he still married to Kim Kardashian?
You're so stupid. They never got married. He just got her pregnant.
Oh, I feel like they're married.
She's still married to the other guy, though.
Oh, that's right. She's still married to the other guy, and that's a big scandal because...
Latina.
Yeah.
Slutina.
She's like out of baby out of wedlock or something. Well, she's married to another guy.
I mean, who cares about a baby out of wedlock?
Yeah.
Like, don't be married to another dude and then having sex with them. I mean, she's probably having sex with several of them.
Oh, probably. There's probably videotapes about it.
Oh, there it is.
Hey, let's watch one.
So then the other thing is Justin Bieber. I know everybody loves Justin Bieber.
Oh my gosh, I heard about this. Wasn't he in London and he collapsed and now he's dead or something?
You're so stupid. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, you heard it first on the Cornwall Styling Show.
Justin Bieber is dead. But he's still tweeting naked photos
of
himself.
Yes, he's still tweeting naked photos. We got a clap over here.
Exactly.
Justin Bieber is dead.
Hurrah.
No, Justin Bieber is not dead. He's like acting out. Like he was caught.
He collapsed in London, didn't he?
Nobody gives a shit about him collapsing on stage.
All right.
He was caught out and about in London wearing a gas mask.
Oh, that's right. I heard about that. Yeah.
Whatever that's supposed
what
to mean.
What does that mean? Maybe they have really dirty air in London. But doesn't
well,
he tweet?
Do.
He tweets shirtless photos of himself all
he
the
does.
Time.
He does. He tweets shirtless photos.
Yeah.
Trying to think he's sexy, you know, stuff like that.
Yeah.
But this
I bet he collapsed because he's not eating because that's why he's so skinny and sexy.
He's doing the model thing.
Yeah, he probably.
So now.
He was on Saturday Night Live like a month ago, maybe. He was so awful.
He was awful?
He was awful.
Aww.
Did anybody see that? No, nobody watches SNL.
Nobody watches it because
I just
Justin
happened
Bieber
to watch it
because
I get home from work and I'm tired and you know, I just put it on. But he was so bad. He was like making all these moves like, hey, how's it going? And like fixing his hair while he was singing and stuff. It was really dumb.
Maybe he was on Flexeril like I am right now.
Maybe, yeah. So what's up with that?
It
no, really. James is on a muscle relaxer
I'm
at the moment.
Relaxers.
And you're drinking champagne. Hey, can you pour champagne,
Jackie's
champagne
here,
girl?
Champagne girl. We need to pop the bottles. Come on, let's
so
do it.
So what's up with that? You're on a muscle relaxer.
Yeah, muscle relaxer.
You hurt your back?
A good friend of mine gave me a muscle relaxer.
I can't imagine who that would be. I don't know anybody who has a pharmacy in their cabinet in their kitchen.
Tim Coburn with his pharmacy at home. I have... It actually feels really good. I'm
I'm
shit,
sure.
That was right.
If anybody needs prescription medication... I'm your
I hope Black Angel Down doesn't mind me feeling all loopy.
I'm sure they'll be fine with it.
Yeah.
They look a little loopy over there themselves, actually.
I love it. But no, back to the real story about real Justin story. Bieber yeah. was...
Oh, I forgot all about that.
He, like, his bodyguard had to, like, fight him off the paparazzi.
Yeah.
Because they were saying, you little fucker, you little bitch, go back to USA.
What?
Oh, yeah. They were, like, cussing him out, and he, like, leaps out of the van. And
wearing a gas mask.
Going at the... he was holding his dick. Oh, get oh. to British people. Yeah.
Wow, that's
so,
very American.
But here's the best part. So his... on again, off again, girlfriend Selena Gomez, she just released a video. She and five friends did a video completely choreographed to the song Your Boyfriend is a Douchebag.
What?
Yes, it has gone viral on
oh
YouTube.
Oh my gosh.
And it's getting all these hits on there. And then at the end, they're like lip syncing, but they're doing the whole rap to yeah. Your Boyfriend's a Douchebag.
Your Boyfriend's a Douchebag.
Yeah, it's
very
funny. Really, really funny. You guys should, you know, play on YouTube more. It's really fun when you're like high off of Flex.
I'm sure anything's fun when you're high on Flex Thrill and Vicodin together.
Yes. No Vicodin, no Vicodin.
No
just
Vicodin.
Flex Thrill and alcohol.
Fabulous.
Yeah, so
your liver must be proud.
So my friends, our friends at All Things
Muchos
Specialty.
Gracias.
Thank you, Jackie. You're so amazing.
Jackie the Champagne Girl.
All Things Fashion DC, go see what's up for this coming week. There's lots of charity events. There's lots of great stuff happening in town.
Yes.
So you have to go visit allthingsfashiondc.com and get the latest poop and scoop on where you need to be fashion-wise, politically-wise, and event-wise.
Event-wise, yes. Lots yes. of good stuff going on.
Absolutely. And what's going on with you, Mr. Coburn?
What do you mean?
Aren't there some great things happening? Are you allowed to talk about any of it?
I'm not really sure what you mean.
Oh my God, you're so tragic.
What amazing things are happening?
Men's shoot. Can we talk about the possible?
No, we can't talk about that.
See?
We can't talk about that.
What about F-10 fighter pilots?
We can talk about that.
We can talk about that. Is that happening? Do we know?
I don't think it's happening, but we can talk about it.
All right.
Go ahead.
You're so
no, it's
stupid.
Not that exciting. We were supposed to shoot a bunch of Marines, mm-hmm. like 20 Marines out on the tarmac in San Diego this week.
Yes.
But I don't think it's happening, so it's not exciting anymore.
Yeah, but we're also supposed to shoot the F-10 fighter
pilots. We're supposed to do the same thing
in
Quantico here in D.C.
Quantico.
Yes.
They're going to let our asses on a secured facility.
A secured facility out on the tarmac to shoot.
I'm not so sure about that.
To shoot men in fighter jets.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's actually very exciting, but the woman that we're dealing with in order to get this done is not exciting.
She's a little crazy. She's special.
She's crazy.
She's special. But I like that. So. Hopefully we can do some locker room scenes. Do they have a locker room there?
Yeah.
Is there
of course they
a
do.
Locker room?
They have a whole gym there,
actually.
Is it like
the Marine scrub room?
We can get them all slutty and put them in aviators. Very Top Gun.
Yes. And we can go through the, just line them up and see who has
yeah,
the Top
Gun.
Yeah,
they take my breath away.
Yeah. Oh my God, you're so stupid right now. I can't even handle you.
I know.
Okay, so.
Yes, pour the champagne on it.
Are you
people
guys?
People are waiting.
Are you guys ready for Black Angel Down?
I'm born ready. I want to hear all about this.
Is everybody here from Black Angel Down? No?
Nokia's
we're
missing.
Waiting on well, we still have a few minutes. Like,
okay.
Yeah, you know,
we should introduce my family. I have family here today. Yeah,
family?
No?
Do you want
to
come up?
We don't have introduced? To. I have... Okay, so... can I talk? Yeah. So long story short, I'm adopted... And I, yeah.
Meaning you were born under a rock.
Yes. And I seeked out my birth parents, birth mother, birth father. And I found my birth father. And it turns out, as I found him, he has two other children. And one of them, my amazing half-sister, is here. I think she should
Yay.
Say hi. She's here with her husband, Ian. They're both from Washington State, and they're here with their newborn baby.
Her husband's really hot.
Only 8 weeks old. I know, her husband is hot.
He's really hot.
But I can't say that because she's in the room.
You didn't tell me it was hot.
He's kind of like rustic and
yeah.
dirty. And yeah.
Well, I mean, crunchy.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yeah. I told you this. Oh, yeah, they're them. That's my
them.
Good friend, Todd.
That's
don't we
them.
Look alike? Yeah, or yeah.
And who are these other tragic people that are here?
Those are her friends. They used to live in Washington State, but now they live in the District of Corruption.
Oh.
And they are here, so she's here visiting them because they live in Grundy, Virginia, which is like nobody's ever heard of this place.
She knows where Grundy, Virginia is.
You know where Grundy? How do you know Grundy?
How do you know Grundy, Virginia? I'm from Virginia. I didn't know Grundy.
They live in Grundy.
I thought I had been every place in Virginia because I've traveled the countryside.
Anyway, so
never
heard of
Grundy.
They're moving back to Washington State, so they're just here for the weekend. Yeah, so I'm very excited. Yeah, it's really cool. We're all going out to dinner tonight. You guys aren't invited. Very sorry. Hey, Todd, you're invited.
Well, I was invited, but I declined.
Yeah, he declined.
You guys don't have enough pot for me.
Or muscle relaxers.
Yeah. Exactly.
Anyway.
Anybody else you want to introduce?
No, that's it.
Well, we have to see the mascot. He's back.
Oh, he's so cute.
Milani, bring Gunther over.
Gunther.
This
what
is
kind
Gunther.
Of a name for a dog is Gunther?
Isn't he the cutest
I just love it.
Thing
he
ever?
He is so cute. How old is he?
My baby.
4 months. And what kind of dog is he?
He's an Orope.
Oh, he just looks like a warm blanket.
Hi,
oh my except God. For when he touches your face so like that. That's disgusting.
He gives you kisses.
No, he doesn't. He gives you bacteria.
You let all kinds of boys lick your face.
I let them lick my booty, too.
The sweet hoe.
Oh,
my God.
Look at
so crazy.
There's a baby in the room.
Oh, there is. Is that a little? That's a. Oh my
that's
God,
my half-nephew.
It's your family member.
Oh, he's so cute.
Oh, my God. He's tiny.
He's tiny.
How
he's
old?
Only 8 weeks old.
8 weeks old. You guys are brave.
I know. You guys are really brave. They're toting him around. They drove up here 8 hours with the baby.
Oh, my
8 hours,
God.
Right? And they're just running around D.C. with him. Whatever. Up late. We're going out to dinner at like 8:30 at night. They're like, whatever.
Oh, yeah. My God. That's
they're
out
brave.
Of control.
Well, they're new. They're new parents. So they're testing it. They're just seeing
testes,
how
testes,
it works.
1, 2.
Exactly.
Testes.
Exactly. I think when you have a second child, it's like, oh, no, you know better maybe, you know? It's like.
Whatever.
Yeah.
All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to play a fabulous song.
Okay.
And I know all of you guys are Mariah Carey lovers, right? Yeah. All right, so I'm going to see the new. Shut up, Todd. Nobody asked you. Yeah, ass sitting over there. Who has seen Oz in here yet? Anybody? Oz, the Great and Powerful. No. I'm going to see Oz tomorrow, and I can't wait. And this is one of the big songs from the movie. So I hope you
enjoy it.
Is
it a Mariah Carey song?
It's a Mariah Carey song. Imagine that. Of course. Are you kidding me? There's nothing. Well, besides Black Angel Down, there's nothing better than Mariah Carey.
Of course.
Did you guys like that?
Way to save it, James.
Did you like that? Okay, here we go. Enjoy. And when we come back, we are going to have Black Angel Down.
Amazing.
But we're still waiting on Nokia.
Yeah.
Get your ass here, man.
Isn't he the lead singer?
I've seen the light in the sky. In the skies are like fireflies. Burning bright, just to vanish in the dark.
Oh,
Oh my gosh, I love that song.
Oh, don't be a sarcastic bitch.
Okay, all right. I've never heard it in my life, and it sounded like every other Mariah Carey song. Actually, it was very triumphant. You know what it sounded like? A Jordan Sparks Mariah American Idol song.
Well, it's for Disney. It's for the movie.
Yeah,
Oz,
it sounded very Disney.
Yeah, so she wrote it specifically for the movie, and it's really awesome. Oh my God, you're so tragic. I love
Mariah Carey.
She's, oh, come on. She's been doing big things, man.
She has. She's on American Idol.
And she's on American
Idol. Oh my gosh, and she's bronzed out to death. First of all, her tits are up to here, and they're like orange, shiny, and glittery, and she's like, oh, I love your song. Oh my gosh, she's so ridiculous.
I tried so hard to find that picture of her last week. Did any of you guys see it? Where she had this black, like, patent leather look dress on, and the whole front was see-through. And I mean, her tits were smashed in there. And
oh my God.
It was like the Grand Canyon.
Oh, wow.
I mean, she, it was. I'm telling you what, she's taking care of Nick Cannon, though.
Uh-huh.
I was hoping after she gave birth that she was going to get a reduction, but apparently she didn't. Okay. I am just saying.
Okay.
Okay. So this week's show, we'll talk about our sponsors. Does that sound good?
Oh, now?
Yeah.
Oh, sure. Yeah. I mean, okay.
We have time to kill, so... This week's show is sponsored by Softbox Studios.
Oh my God! And
what?
Tim Coburn Photography.
Oh, who's that?
TimCoburnPhoto.com.
Tim Coburn Photography did not write a check for this bullshit. But Softbox Studios doing big things, people. It's full of photographers now. It's so amazing.
I know, it is. It's very exciting.
Out in Fairfax, Virginia, so... If you need.
Yeah, somebody's shooting there in a week, 2 weeks, Jackie.
Jackie,
right? Yeah,
you're gonna be shooting at Softbox
with Janet. Where's Janet?
Right there.
No, not Janet. I always do this.
Oh, January. January could not be here tonight, hence while I have both phones.
Oh, right. Got it.
Got a new job.
Oh.
And she is now working at Nordstrom.
So she's not working for you for free anymore.
She is working for me for free, but not for very long. I think after this she's fired.
Because she's because she didn't show up?
Wait, she's an intern. I'm not sure I could fire her.
Oh, you can fire an intern?
You can fire an intern?
Yeah, I think. Why not?
Can you fire an intern?
I'm sorry, it's just not working out.
Can you fire an intern? Ah, yes! Fire her!
Fire her! She's from Virginia anyway.
Yes! Oh. We're from Virginia.
Virginia.
I know, right? I am just saying. So, yeah, so January, she works at Nordstrom.
Got it. Okay. All right, well.
Absolutely. Well, I have no content.
No, I think we should just interview.
You think so?
Yeah.
How far is Nokia away?
He was 5 minutes away 5 minutes ago. Oh, I think he's here.
Is he in the building? For all you people listening at home, I apologize.
This happened once before when we were waiting for someone. Who was it that we were waiting for?
It wasn't Maya. Maya was right on time.
Of course.
You guys want to come over and have a seat and start the interview?
Yeah, you guys should just sing to us.
You guys, Black Angel Down!
Minus the lead singer.
Sans Nokia.
I love it.
Baltimore.
Oh,
wait.
Yeah.
I thought I said Baltimore.
Baltimore. Show
Look, there he is.
There he is.
We need it. Yeah, you guys can move on around a little bit.
Oh, he went to the other radio station.
No.
He went to visit Olivia Fox.
Do you want some champagne?
No, hold up. No. I have presents for you guys.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. See, my co-host knows shit.
Well, if I had like anything. A list of something that was going on, maybe I would know. It would say here, don't mention champagne. I have presents.
Yeah. All right. So please, let's go down the line. You guys introduce yourselves. Tell us what your role is in the band. We're going to start up here.
My name is Dirty Ralph, and I play the guitar.
Oh, hey, Dirty Ralph.
And yes. I also provide background vocals.
Awesome.
And spankings.
I'm Kevin. I play bass.
All right.
Cool.
Dan, drums.
We know who you are.
Okay, cool.
No, I'm just kidding.
No, this is Nokio. I do lead vocals. I just work here, though.
I just work here. I love it. You in there?
Rod on the guitar.
Well, I have presents for you guys. Somebody told me, January told me that you guys like beer.
Oh.
They were like either water or beer, but I see some of y'all partaking in
the champagne. That's cool too. All right.
So I went all out.
Oh,
and
wow.
I got you guys some really good beer.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh.
It's a six-pack of Pabst Blue Ribbon.
Pabst Blue Ribbon.
Here you go. Pass them on
the
down.
The creme de la creme of beer.
I thought you guys would enjoy it. I told Tim, I said, I haven't bought a six-pack of Pabst Blue Ribbon since fucking high school. When it was Boone's Farm and Pabst Blue Ribbon.
That was three hard-earned dollars.
Okay, so who wants the last Pabst Blue Ribbon? Oh, look at Eric.
Of course,
our
Eric
control, our board worker
he
over there.
He is a alky and a stoner.
It's his payment.
But we love you.
You want a good show, right?
Yeah. Psychedelic.
We get a good show afterwards.
Right? All right, cheers, guys.
Cheers, you guys. Cheers. Black Angel right. Down. Thank you so much for being on the Cornwell Styling Show. If you can pull that microphone forward if you need to. Yeah, so you can get up in there. All right, so, you know, first off, like, tell us what's up. Tell us what's the idea behind Black Angel Down.
It was pretty much a collaborative effort and idea. Dan and Kevin playing a band called the Mind Factor, which I used to manage about 10 years ago or so.
Okay. Oh, wow.
So that's how our relationship started. And, you know, I always wanted to do rock music, but it was always a thing where it was like, okay, I manage the band. Like, I can't, like, sing in the band and manage the, conflict of interest going on. So maybe about 3-4 years ago now, Kevin came to me and he said, man, you ever think about singing in a rock band? And I was like, yes.
Every day.
I love it.
So, you know.
Jedi mind tricked
us. Yeah.
So we started just going in, doing sessions. You know, Ralph was actually part of the original sessions when we first started recording. And then, you know, Dan came in. Rod came in, you know, we had some other people that were involved on the project, Frank Marchand, Adam, Sean, Matt, just a lot of Teo from Drew Hill was also involved in the project.
Oh,
so,
cool.
You know, it's just been a cool ride, man, to, you know, just make the transition, be around people that you know and be able to make great music and have fun.
That's awesome. That's really, so, what I mean, was it a hard transition into rock and roll? I mean, rock and roll does have a different sound. It's got a different feel.
It's so different.
Like,
I mean, not for these. I mean, these guys are all like legends in Baltimore as far as the rock scene. Like, you know, it's like everywhere. It's the truth. It's like everywhere. It's like everywhere you go. You know, I mean, like just as far as the basis and foundation of what rock music is in Baltimore, all these guys have been a part of it.
Right.
So, you know, me coming into it, like I didn't know what to do. I tell you, like, my first session, I'm like in the studio and I'm like, okay, look, like, I've never really been produced. Like, I've always been the producer, so you guys tell me what to do. So, like, I sang the song the first time. When was the first song that we did? And I sang it the first time, and I mean, it wasn't trash, but it wasn't rock and roll. So, you know, Kevin and our engineer Frank called me up and said, hey, why don't you just come sing it like one more time? Like, we'll keep the vocal you got, but just sing it one more time over top of that vocal. And just so I did it. And from there, you know, we just started getting in there, you know, getting drunk and writing songs.
So was it like too smooth and too pretty, like as far as your vocals? Or
I just didn't. I mean, I think that like I said, I didn't know how to approach it. Really.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
I'm just, like I said, usually I'm the writer, I'm the producer, I'm the one like, hey, do this,
right.
Do this. So I'm just standing there and I'm like, okay, I'm just glad that I remember the words.
So who wrote the song?
I did that one. And I mean, to his credit, he got it real quick and just
kind of ran away with the rest of the album. Just we combined his style of vocals with a heavy kind of groove style of rock and roll music, and I thought the blend, you know, has never been done before, and it fits perfectly together. I think he's got a real way about approaching this style of music with his style of vocals that works perfectly.
Right.
That's cool. That is so cool. So how long have you guys been working together?
It's been about 4 years now, almost.
Yeah,
four
I was going to say about 2009.
Yeah. So just about 4 years.
Tail end of 2009.
Yeah.
And you're all Baltimore based, or some of you are from D.C.?
All Baltimore.
You're all Baltimore.
All of you.
Baltimore.
Uh-huh. Well, I've lived in Baltimore for 13 years.
Oh, okay.
Me too. I'm originally from here.
Oh, excellent.
I'm originally from California.
Oh.
I actually was born in Washington State.
Hey, there you go. We have an audience in here from Washington State tonight. That's awesome.
Yeah. Sorry, I blanked there.
That's hilarious. So what, you guys, one of the big things, you have something coming up. Who wants to talk about that? Who wants to give us a scoop on the big show?
Oh, yeah, South by. We're going to be performing, doing South by Southwest this week. We're doing a showcase with Landshark Promotion Company. And it's really cool because Gary J, who owns the company, he heard Wynn about a year and a half ago.
Mm-hmm.
And... you know, he called us up and he was like, look, man, I hear a lot of songs. You know, as you can see, I work with a lot of bands. You know, his roster is like ridiculous.
Yeah.
I mean, everybody in the world. And he's like, I get records from bands all the time, my friends, you know, whatever. And I never want to take on anybody that I hear, you know, no discredit to him or whatever. But he was like, when I heard this song, I was like, these guys got it. And we got to figure out a way to work together. So last year, he invited us down, but I had a show the same day with Drew Hill in Houston, I think it was. And I'm like trying to figure out, well, how can I drive from Houston to Austin and get there? It was just too much to figure out. So, you know, we were part of the compilation CD that he did for the showcase last
very
year.
Cool.
And then this year, it was just like, actually, I got a call from Kevin and Dan, and it was like, we going, and that's it. It's like, we going, and that's it. Like, I don't care what you had to do, like, we going. So, you know, it's an honor to, you know, just be recognized by your peers.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
you know
yeah.
what I mean? Especially, you know, for me, like I said, just spending the last, I don't even want to say how long now, doing honor. It's been a long time. And the funny thing is, we actually started right across the street at Howard University. That's where we auditioned to get our first record deal.
Are you serious?
Absolutely.
Oh, wow.
Let's see, if I remember correctly, you were
14 years old?
Yep.
Wow.
That's why I don't really want to talk about how long I've been doing it.
You did your Google search before you came here.
I did a little bit of homework. Well, one of my questions is doing this because, you know, we have cool, interesting, amazing people in here all the time. Do you get tired of people always bringing up Drew Hill, or is that still a part of everything that's going on now?
I mean, it's always going to be a part, you know, it's the foundation of me and music. But the funny thing is, like, when we do shows, I mean, once in a while you might get somebody that's like, oh yeah, that's the guy from Drew, that's
yeah.
not or whatever. But it's after the fact.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
like after the show, which for me makes it a lot better, because, you know, like I said to you guys, and I almost feel bad when we like advertise the bands like Black Angel Down featuring Nokio from Drill, because I don't want anybody to like compare it. I don't want them to think they come in to see like a rock band sing a bunch of sad songs or sex songs or something like that. You know, so for the people that do recognize it, and for it to be afterwards, like, you know, it kind of helps everything a lot, because it makes me feel like people are there really to see the music and see what we're doing, not
right.
just like to see, well, what's the comparison to,
yeah.
you know, everything else.
Because
yeah.
I know that happens. So, I mean, poor Mariah can't get past Glitter to save her
oh.
life. So, you know.
Unfortunately, we're all scarred from that experience. Sometimes you can't, you know.
Yeah.
That's right. Yes. Oh God, I love it. You guys are awesome.
Yeah, thanks, man.
So, any big album releases, songs?
Well, I mean, we're getting up, just, you know, riding the momentum from South by Southwest and everything. You know, we just finished our new video, which is kind of a re-release of Wynn and also gearing up to release the full album. Because initially we just did an EP, and it really wasn't for anything other than just to get the music out there, you know, see what people think, you know, build up fan base and everything like that. And just slowly but surely, like, one thing that I was real adamant about was like, okay, whatever it is that rock bands do, because like I said, I didn't know, you know, I was like,
they tear up hotel rooms and break bottles everywhere.
That's pretty much
guitars,
it. They break the guitars on stage.
Whatever it is that rock bands do to along the path to greatness, you know, like, that's what I want to do. Like, whatever, you know, playing the bars, whatever the gigs are, whatever it is that you have to do, like, I want to do that. Like, I don't want it to, you know, be like, and we laugh about it sometimes, like, hey man, you know, why don't you just pick up the phone and call, you know, whoever. And it, you know.
Yeah, right?
You know, it's like, all that is cool, but, you know, what I've seen and appreciated, like I said, just getting out here with these other bands that, you know, are also great, you know, musicians and everything else, and to do a show and have them come to you and say, man, like, that was really, like, yeah, like, that was really awesome, or that was really, like, it's real rock. Like, I didn't know what to expect. Like, I didn't know if, you know, like, somebody, you know, it was like some hip hop we were just going to start playing and you was going to start rapping or something. I don't know. like, you know, just for it to really, you know, have a foundation in what rock music is and to go out and do shows and be appreciated and have fans, you know, growing all over the world. Like, you know, that's always, it's my dream.
Right.
Like, there's really no substitute to, like, paying your dues in those clubs. You know, it's kind of like learning Spanish in Spain rather than, like, you know, out of a book. You know, you have to go through and play on all those kind of off nights and meet the people and play in front of the bartender and kind of gel, and then all of a sudden the wave and the momentum starts and people start coming out and digging your music, and it starts to become like ESP.
And all that informs the music, you know.
Yeah, that's absolutely.
That's what keeps it exciting for all of us.
Yeah. That's amazing.
Yeah, I had my rock star night actually over in Tacoma Station.
I want to know more about that.
Okay. So
he's an instigator, obviously.
Right.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
So we, you know, we started out, you know, doing Thursday nights at Tacoma Station. Mm-hmm. And I remember, like, the first night I showed up, somebody looked at me and was like, okay, like, what are you doing here? And I'm like, all right, I'm here with my rock band. Like, I'm not here to you know, Drew Hill's not here performing. I'm here.
Yeah.
It was kind of, you know, like, paid rehearsal for us. So one night, it was like a really slow night. And we would get there before everybody got there. So I'm just, like, sitting at the bar, and I'm like, yeah, I'm going to drink a Long Island.
Oh no!
I mean,
it's trouble already.
Whatever. It's like,
yeah.
Still nobody here. I'm gonna drink another one.
Drink another one.
So four Long Islands into the night.
Oh, four? Shit!
Oh my god.
Well, I mean, if we compare that to my teenage years, okay, you know, that was just like, you know, too much sugar in the Kool-Aid.
I see.
You know. Yeah, so, but not now.
Right.
You know, people listening, papers and stuff. So I go to the front of the stage, and my intent was just to stand at the front of the stage.
Oh my gosh.
But I started walking off into the invisible catwalk that was on the stage.
Oh, no.
And I somehow ended up on the ground. But I made it back up on the stage to finish the show. And then I somehow woke up the next morning and I had like a scrape on my nose and like on my forehead and whatever. And I just, that part I don't really remember.
Remember?
But I got home safely.
There you go.
Oh,
you
that's know, important.
I didn't black out going home.
That
know,
was the rock star moment right there.
Yeah, I have a headache just listening to that story.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
So I love the little remix we had going on back here, a little R. Kelly baby sound in the background.
Oh yeah, that was nice.
Reminiscent of Aaliyah.
That was nice.
Got the baby in the background.
Yeah. Oh, so I want to hear this song when?
Eric, do we have the video? January,
she's
sending
looking
the video.
Like, what?
She didn't
no,
send
she
it
didn't
to
send it.
She never sent me a video.
Oh.
Oh. You guys don't have it on your phones? I mean, it's your song.
I didn't post it.
The new video.
Yeah, the new video.
Okay, I'm pretty.
It's not done yet, right?
I thought you were CC'd
it done? It's done.
It's done, but
hold on. Let me see if I can find it here.
This is the power of technology.
Are we allowed to play it?
Yeah.
Or no?
Just you. Just you.
Yeah, it's not. It's not. It's not.
No, didn't you send it to January, right?
Yeah.
What?
We're just gonna
January.
In trouble.
She's fired.
Yeah. No, she's an intern. You can't fire her.
Yeah, that's. A, can you fire?
Yeah.
April, actually. It should
We're gonna
be
have
April.
To make you guys sing it live.
She told us that before the champagne.
I know, right?
Right, exactly. Wait a minute.
Hold on, I don't.
Just hum all your parts.
Yeah, we can give you some sticks and you can bang on the table. I mean, whatever.
Damn.
I mean, I can send it. I'm sure nobody wants to, like, shout their phone number off.
Oh, I don't care.
Worldwide.
You want to just play it on your phone?
Oh, yeah,
you want to play the song or you want to see the video?
Well, whatever. Whatever's faster, easier.
Okay. Because I could send you the link real fast.
Yeah, send it. Send it to James.
Okay.
At jamescornwell.com. I didn't want to get ahead of him there. Bitch, what you playing about over there?
This is
okay.
A video broadcast radio show. How can you not play a video?
Because you guys never gave me a video.
Oh.
We're gonna play the song. How about
okay,
that?
Okay. All right. There we go.
All right. So you guys, what's this called? Wind?
Yes.
All right, you guys. This is an exclusive.
Black
on the
Angel
Cornwell
Down.
Sonic Show. Wind. Black Angel Down. Here we go. Hope you guys enjoy it. Tweet us at Cornwell Styling. Text us. You have the phone number because it's up online. Let us know what you think.
gosh, you sound just like him.
Right?
I'm going down.
Yeah. You better watch
Black
out.
Black Angel down.
Wow, that is a big difference from Drew Hill.
Yeah.
That was awesome.
You guys all sound amazing. That is so cool.
Thank you. Thanks.
That is awesome. So anybody here in the audience have any questions? How long? What was the question?
We fly
how
in
long
on,
are we going to be at South by Southwest?
We fly in Friday, play Saturday, fly home Sunday.
Or 200 margaritas, whatever comes first.
Oh, yeah. Excellent. So I have a really stupid question. Where is it?
Austin, Texas.
Austin. Okay, cool. It's like a really big town. I've heard of it. I just wasn't sure. Anybody know that?
It's art, film, technology.
The address of the place right off hand?
611? 611 8th Street, I think.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Awesome.
It's the main strip. 6th
Street. Yeah, 6th Street. 611 H or something.
Oh, I thought you said 888?
Yeah, no.
6th Street.
I think the champagne's good.
The Bayou Lounge, 500 East Street.
Oh, there it is.
6th Street, Austin, Texas.
Thank you, Internet.
SXSW.
Again, the power of technology.
Yeah, I know.
Never rely on the artist to know where they're supposed to be.
I have a picture of your flyer.
Oh, let me see.
Oh, yeah.
That is a cool flyer. Wow. Do you guys have a band photo? Like all of you together?
This is it right now. Yes. Didn't he just take
right,
one?
Yeah,
oh,
he did
take with his iPhone.
He was taking some photos.
We got a...
Any of you people back there have questions?
We got a local show coming up too.
Oh, where's that?
Rams Head Live in Baltimore next month. Drew Hill and Black Angel Down, same bill.
It's going to be huge.
Oh, wow.
Huh?
Is
Cisco going to perform? I don't know yet.
But it's going
to
be...
He's like, why you got to bring up Cisco?
That means we have to travel to Baltimore?
Yeah.
Yeah. What?
There's something about D.C. people not wanting to go to Baltimore.
Well, it's always been like that.
It's always,
like,
yeah,
as long
it
as
is.
I can
crazy.
Remember.
It's 45 minutes.
It's all. Yeah, it's probably vice versa, too.
We didn't mind coming here.
Love it.
That's because you guys
love
are
it.
Love.
That is amazing. Any questions? Any more questions?
You know what? If you need us to come pick you up to take you to Baltimore for this show, it's worth it.
There you go. Bring it down to Baltimore.
That is an offer. Wait, what kind of car is it going to be? I'm kind of bougie. I need something.
We actually did
Party bus.
Cover of Drew Hill's How Deep Is Your Love.
Oh, wow.
I love that. There's a sigh happening over here.
Now, that's cool.
Oh, wow.
And we shot that whole ride.
Yeah, we just
shot in the club that we played in.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Was there part of the video that you couldn't put in the music video?
No.
Yeah, I'm sure.
No.
I want to see the outtakes.
Yeah, but we got in trouble with the club.
Remember when he was saying that you need to get more into the YouTube thing?
Yeah. I see reality show now. It should be like, what was that rock guy?
So, yeah.
Rock of Love bus. You guys need like
the
Black Angel
yes,
Down bus.
Black
oh
Angel Down bus.
That guy right there.
Hey, when we
what?
Were,
the Dirty Ralph show.
So
Dirty
both, Ralph, both of you. There's
like
videos
the
of
show.
Both of you.
I like what, the Dirty
you.
Ralph show.
What did I do?
Wait,
I
Nokia don't know. Got in trouble at the club.
Yeah, we got
what
trip.
Happened at the club?
No,
were you drinking Long Island again?
See, because this would be misconstrued into something that did not happen.
And by that you mean the
and
truth?
And I've already no, not the truth, because I've already been
it's in the video.
Chastised about
it's
this.
It's in the video.
So this is what happened.
Camera doesn't lie.
We're all listening.
This is what happened.
The camera doesn't lie.
Look, man, I'm married.
This is TMZ.com right now.
So so what happened was actually,
what happened was
I love. He's like making up his story, right?
No,
he's
I'm telling you what happened. My wife wrote the treatment to the video, so she said it was a part of the video where it should seem like I'm making out with the girl. Mm-hmm. So it was like, okay, cool.
Uh-huh.
All right, it was like, all right, cool. So, like, you are so stupid, man. So you know, we were like in this corner. It was supposed to be in the bathroom, but like we couldn't shoot in the bathroom on the bus. It was just too small.
Oh yeah.
And the bathroom in the club just wasn't going to work. So it's like a corner. If you see the video, it's like all these posters up and stuff. So we were back there shooting. Now, like, I'm standing in front of the girl. We weren't doing nothing or whatever. But the owner, whoever it was at the club, the promoter was like, can you tell them to stop making out or doing whatever or having sex in the corner?
Oh.
I'm like, what are you? I didn't find this out until afterwards. Uh-huh. But, you know, I guess if you're just standing behind somebody and you see them standing there, you might think that. But,
I see.
You know,
I see.
It was nothing.
It's like hard to tell if people are just standing there having sex.
I mean, you know, it depends on the angle. But, you know what I'm saying?
You know, if you Google him on you or Google him or go on YouTube, you'll see some stuff that you're like, no, that can't be happening.
Oh,
I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed.
Actually, I think it's sextube.com, isn't it?
Oh, man.
It's called RedTube.
No, it's RedTube. Yeah, RedTube. Yeah.
Pornhub.
Wow, there's there is way too many shout outs.
Yeah. Right, way too many.
Isn't it Scat Lover?
Yes.
Yeah. I like music.
Wow. We would love to be sponsored by sextube.com.
Coming out right now. Don't they have an Xtube? That's what it is, Xtube.
Yes,
yeah, hot. Good stuff.
Anybody listening that can hook us up with xtube.com?
It's an X-Hamster.
Yeah, yeah.
What's that website you were talking about earlier?
Which one?
Oh, Backpage?
Backpage.com. What is that?
Backpage?
No, Backpage.
Backpage.
Which is less important, actually, than BlackAngelDown.com.
Well, yes, of course.
Yeah, well, somebody, we found out that somebody had been hacking our site.
Oh, seriously?
And it's like the second time that it got suspended.
Yeah.
No. So I see a message today from that popped up in our email talking about posts from Backpage.com. Now, nobody here knew what it was or who was doing it. You know, so I sent a message to everybody, okay, now who's been on Backpage.com?
Right.
Now, I mean, we'll just leave it at that because everybody said no.
Right.
But, I mean.
No, we're sticking to that.
Yeah. I mean, for.
This is a story.
But. What is Backpage.com?
Yeah.
Yeah, we should just leave it at that.
Well, I was going to say, I was going to get it mixed up with Backdoor.com.
Oh, that's what I'm thinking.
Close enough.
But like
there you go.
Backpage.com, I guess, is it's like Craigslist. Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Well, I have to say a quick shout out because I have a really good friend who I'm sure you know. And I know she loves you, Maya. She's my girl.
What's up, Maya?
She might be listening to us right now. Yeah, she's doing great. So I had to say that.
Hi, Maya.
And let me tell you what, she's looking fine these days,
too. Okay.
She's always looking fine. Man. Maya is one of those.
She's beautiful.
A girl can sing.
I know.
She's going to be back. She's going to be back home March 18th, I think, for the DC Tap Fest. Good times. Anyway, so, all right, how can we find Black Angel Down?
Well, you could find us on blackangeldown.com if this guy doesn't quit spamming people.
I know, really.
From some site that we don't, I mean, like, we didn't, like, it was the second time that, because we have, you know, post every day, go to blackangeldown.com. People are like, your account is suspended. I'm like, what are you talking about? I was just on there. So, you know, we're trying to get the security of that. Funny story. The last time that it got hacked, when you went to blackangeldown.com,
This is my. This is what I want to know. Like, how does it get hacked?
It was like it was almost
like he doesn't want
to
know.
No, right? For real. It's like you went to the page and it was like some skulls and like all this Arabic and stuff going on. And I'm like, whoa,
what's up with that?
You know, like it was crazy. This time, we just found out that somebody was spamming us. But the first time, it got hacked by some. I don't know what it was, but it wasn't us.
Crazy
but
people.
We have a Black Angel Down page on Facebook, Twitter.
Twitter's really starting to blow up.
At Black Angel Down, right?
Yeah.
Yes, I think I started following you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Awesome.
Or I might be lying.
We'll find out.
I have to double check. You can start following
me. Yeah,
you now.
Really.
Austin, Texas.
Austin, Texas.
When is that?
That's this Saturday. Saturday, March 16th.
Awesome.
April 26th, Rams here live, Baltimore, Black Angels Down, Drew Hill.
Anything coming for DC?
Not yet.
Not yet? We need to make that happen.
We need to make it happen.
Make it happen.
Yeah.
Yeah, hell yeah. We got some connections over there.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, we would, we, you know,
not that you need them, but shit.
No, it was a country's crazy. It's a couple shows that came up, but, you know, I guess the hardest thing with this is, like, doing shows on the weekend and then, excuse me, making sure that it's, you know, far enough ahead that we already have, like, a Drew Hill show, you know, booked. So that's, you know, we have got some offers for DC.
Right.
We just couldn't do it.
Right.
Or it's not conflicting with my posting to RedTube.
I bet those are good videos.
His name's Manuel Hung.
Manuel Hung. One hung low.
Yeah.
So, can you give us any like new music, any new songs, inspiration?
Cinematographer for Bang Bus. What did you say?
Bang
Bus. Bang Bus. I thought it was Bait Bus.
Bait Bus.
It's both.
No, that's Straight Men Baited.
Straight Men Baited. Straight There's men so baited. Many of those things.
Are you guys always working on new music? You got?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we got. Like I said, we released the EP and we kept like 4 or 5 songs off of there just to, you know, wait for the album. And, you know, we've been writing new stuff, so, you know.
Awesome.
Yeah, it'll start to come together quick after probably, you know, May, June.
That sounds amazing. Well, we appreciate you guys being on the show.
We love it.
You rock. You guys are a lot of fun.
Thank you.
Awesome. How's the Pabst Blue Ribbon?
PBR.
I tell you what, after my glass of champagne and the Flexer, I'm feeling
like I'm sure this are.
This bitch is feeling right. Flexeril.
It's like a muscle relaxer.
Muscle relaxer.
Flexerol, huh?
And some champagne. Flexerol. This bitch is right. I'm ready to rock out on stage. Where's my guitar?
He's looking at it like he's crazy.
And this has been a public service.
Yes.
Yes, it has.
Kids don't do drugs and alcohol together.
Oh, my gosh. Yes. Yes.
So will you guys take some pictures with our
Absolutely.
Fabulous
Yeah,
crew?
We would love it. Thank you so much.
That would be so amazing. Well, that was just the paparazzi.
Of course. Yeah, oh, I think he's going out to
poop. Milani, they want to take pictures with the dog.
Yeah,
he has to take a shit.
Yeah.
He needs to excuse himself.
Yeah, he's
got to
dump
moment.
It out.
Right.
Oh, post it on scatlover.com.
Awesome. Right. Will you guys rock? Follow Black Angel Down on Twitter.
Yeah, I don't know how these people know all these porn sites. I'm just trying to figure out how to.
And you can see Tim live on analbusters.com.
Analbusters.com. And cumdumpster.com. Also.
So this might not be the best time to say thank you for your support, but
yes,
thank you for
absolutely.
Your
yes, thank you very much.
No, we love you guys. You're awesome. Go like them on. You have a
Facebook page, of course.
Yes.
Go like them on Facebook.
Facebook, not any of the aforementioned websites.
Twitter, yeah, no.
Facebook.
Don't endorse
Facebook,
those.
Black Angel Down and Twitter. You guys rock. And follow at Cornwell Styling, and you can find them on my Twitter.
Awesome. Thank you
so
much.
Thanks, guys. You guys rock. Oh, we have a phone call coming in.
Oh, I hope it's not just...
Hello?
I love that he just answers the phone on the air. Like, hello. Hi. Hey, Mom.
Is it plugged in?
No, it's not plugged in.
Hello?
I know, right?
I know.
Your ass is banned from ever
seriously.
Being on the internet
no
again.
More. It's over.
Question,
oh, well, they're gone. Alrighty.
Awesome. Well, you guys rock.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We appreciate you being here. Absolutely. I'm sure Jackie wants to get in there.
Yes, they all want slutty photos.
Ready. Slutty photos. Who's calling? Thank you, sir.
They're calling back.